Welcome back to At Copy. We're talking with Dr. Wilfredo Tierra, NBI Medical Legal Officer and Head of the NBI Disaster Victim Identification Team in Cagayan de Oro. Questions from Twitter, sir, and Facebook. Anonymous One asks, aside from dental records, are there other ways to identify the remains? You had said it.
Yeah, I said earlier, we can deal with the DNA and, of course, with the fingerprint as the two other major parameters of identification. Mm-mm. We can deal with the minor identifiers later on.
Okay. May tanong rin dito, sir. Yung tanong dito, who helps you financially? Not you personally. I mean, the NBI.
The NBI has its own fund. So, by na nagagamit ng disaster victim identification team. But at the disaster area, may mga coordination kami at collaboration with any with other government agencies.
Uh-oh.
The DOAs, the local government units.
Yes.
So we help each other.
Yeah. No, because it would cost so much money. Like if it's, let's say, Princess of the Stars?
Yes, ma'am.
Does the company pay for the identification?
It's another thing when there is a private entity involved. And in this case, in Cagayan de Oro City and in Iligan City, the government itself is shouldering almost all of the expenses. Mm-hmm. While in the sinking of the Princess of the Stars, there's a private entity involved in partially or augmenting or funding the mm-hmm. operation.
Now, you've made some hard calls on the field. When I was in Cagayan de Oro, number one, when relatives wanted to see the body, a time came where you said, no, you cannot look at the bodies anymore. Why?
Yes, it's when
that
we reach
number one.
Yes, when we reach Cagayan de Oro City, it's a Monday. It's afternoon of Monday, so
yeah,
we.
I was there.
Yeah, we assess the place, and we start the actual operation on a Tuesday. So
yes,
the body is in moderately advanced stage of postmortem decomposition. Yeah. It is not advisable for the relatives to view.
That's what
the decomposing body.
No,
yeah.
I did it with some mothers. Yeah. It was part of my story.
Yeah, we
so
don't really
wrong.
It
yes.
was wrong ethically, professionally.
Yes.
So
yes,
there is no way you can identify the body in that state. So we close the door to the relatives.
Yeah, because they were in the open dump site.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We don't really advise them to take a look, to visually recognize
yes.
the decomposing bodies. We understand na ito, ha, sabihin nila, kanya itong magulang, kanya itong kapatid, kanya itong anak. But it is prone to commit mistake.
Uh-oh.
Yung mga hands, mga pakiramdam.
Uh-oh.
It will not stand, kung makarating man tayo sa court, the scrutiny
Mm-mm.
in the court. And of course, the scientific investigation. We really deal with the scientific manner of investigation.
I was going to say also, sir, that when a body drowns, I didn't know that it changes dramatically.
Yes, mas mabilis po yung kanyang decomposition process.
Pag nalunod.
Opo, mas
Oo.
Madali po siya maging bloated.
Yes.
So, mas madaling ma-decompose.
And everything pops, I'm sorry.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Yes.
It is very, very foul smelling. So,
yes,
we don't want to add psychological, mental, and even moral trauma to the grieving relatives. So, we advise them not to go to the dump site. So, makikita pa nila bakit nasa basurahan.
Yeah.
So we close the door to them and then we advise them to go to a specific place where we can talk at a specific time.
Okay. Somebody identified her husband through the wedding ring.
Mm-hmm.
Paano yun pag ganun, sir? Sigurado siya. Wedding ring nila pareho. Do you give the body?
It is a secondary identifier. Later on, we can base the identification on that. But not during the primary postmortem phase.
Okay.
It is prone also to mistakes because we have experienced na may mga pagkakapare-pareho.
Mm-mm.
Even so, sa suot na sing-sing, kahit sa pangalan, kahit sa tattoo.
Oo, sa tattoo?
Yes, ma'am. I have one experience na kung saan lima na magkakaibigan nasa military, same tattoo.
Oo.
Same age.
Same age.
Same built ng katawan. So, pag nung nakita sila, pare-parehong tattoo, pare-parehong suot nila kasi nasa military, pare-pareho sila. Although, yung mga nameplates nila, name tags, wala na.
Mm-hmm.
So, the relatives are clamoring na ito daw kanya, na ito daw kanya. So, we don't really give in to that. we still resort to a more accurate, more sensitive, more specific manner of identification.
All right. The second hard call you had to make was, at some point you already said, to bury. Because it was a whole debate in Cagayan de Oro. Do we bury now, mass burial? A point came where you said we have to bury temporarily already. You solved the problem of the mayor, actually.
Yeah, there was a suggestion coming from some of the relatives.
Not to bury.
Some of the residents and the mayor himself to commit a mass burial for the dead bodies.
What would the difference be?
I strongly suggest to the mayor not to do that mass burial. I suggest a temporary burial.
Mass burial is you don't identify, ililibing mo na lang,
yes,
tanggapin mo na lang, pikit mata na nandun ang kamag-anak mo.
Yes, ma'am. That's it. That's mass burial. You bury body and body parts unidentified.
Yeah, that's a mass burial.
That's a mass burial. What we do in Cagayan de Oro City and in Iligan City is to temporarily bury. The main difference is that we still preserve the identity of the person. What do I mean by that? So after processing, we tag the body, we do labeling on the body, a case number, and we separate each body, place it in a body bag with the same marking and based on our same recording, and then we bury them. So they are still marked and labeled. So that's the main difference.
All right. Parting words, Dr. Tierra, I guess. Life lessons. I mean, anything, you do this for a living, but clearly there are lessons to be learned.
Yes, there are still, this is a bitter lesson for us. Tragedies, as I know, the Philippines is, I think, third or fourth world's most disaster-prone country. So, we don't have to be complacent about our lives. We have to be prepared in all aspects of our life. And for us, the NBI Disaster Victim Identification Team, we are doing our best, as supported by the management of the NBI, to bring to you your missing loved ones for you to be able to pay your final respect, give them a decent burial, to have a final closure.
Yes.
And for you to start anew and move on with your life.
Yes.
This is, I think, what we are trying for you to understand, to be aware that this is a scientific means of identification that we are doing. And we have to be fully aware of this process.
Yes. All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Chera. I'd
Thank
have
you,
to say, I salute you, and I think you're unsung hero in the Philippines. The whole DBI team. Yes, because frankly speaking, you could have chosen to go abroad and practice this, but you stayed in the Philippines and practiced your profession here. So thank you for that. I think you're doing a great job, frankly.
Thank you,
so thank you. Now that's Head Start today, everyone. I'm Karen Davila. Have a good day. I'll see you again tomorrow. Take care today.